If you haven't already noticed, I love a gardening gadget. If it's going to make my life that little bit easier, that I can focus on other things, then I'm all for it. I'm Danny and this is the Grapevine Garden, and today I'm going to show you the thing that I think is going to completely change my garden experience. If, like me, life gets in the way, you know that your garden, your plot cannot have your undivided attention, your life, your work life, your family life, everything else can get in the way. Holidays, trips away, they always, they're always that anxiety of like, how am I going to water things? How am I going to get that greenhouse watered? Is my tomatoes going to die if I go away? And they hold you, they hold you at ransom. And my garden is no longer going to hold me at ransom. So this summer, if I do go away for a few days, I'm not going to worry about the tomatoes in the greenhouse and the peppers and the chilies. So everything will be watering itself. I've got a system in place that is going to be completely dependent on itself, and it's going to be very self-sufficient. So it's powered by solar and it uses a water butt for the water source, and it lasts about a week. So I'm going to set it up now and hopefully the rain will stay off. I chose this day thinking it would be fair, and I didn't want it too hot in the greenhouse to be fitting all the irrigation around. So let's get it done. So what you get inside the box is some irrigation piping, some T-junctions, and then as simple as that, the solar panel kit. This one's a bit bigger than the 12. I think the 12 is only half the size of this, so obviously more to pump around, more power is needed. So I'm going to fit this to a post that I'm going to fit on the plot, and then I'm going to run all the irrigation into the greenhouse. I'm not going to do 24 stations inside the greenhouse this year because I want to try this out, but I am going to run some outside as well so that it will keep my blueberries nice and watered as well, but I'll do that on a future date. So today I'm just going to fit this up to the greenhouse, and then hopefully this will solve my watering problems. So the good thing about this system as well is that not only can you water all your plants on the ground, with the 24 system as well, you can actually run an extra irrigation up and water your hanging baskets as well. So I might look into getting one of these for the garden as well, because some of my hanging baskets are so high on the house, they're hard to water on time. So I think this might be another problem that, well, one of my problems that can be solved. So yeah, right, let's get this all sorted out. So what I've got is there's two contacts here, so when these go into the barrel, they make contact with the water, so it tells the pump that there's water in the barrel for it to work. I've added this, a bolt onto this as well to give it a bit of weight so it drops to the bottom, and then this will go to the bottom of the barrel-ish, and it makes contact. Right, let's fit up the irrigation. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to fit some irrigation from the pump on the left side, like so. So the left side is where the water gets siphoned up, and this filter is added to the bottom. It's got two marbles in it, so it's weighted. And also this piece is an anti-siphon. So basically the pump stops pumping water around. This will stop it from continuously, pumping out through gravity, because my water barrel is a little bit higher than the first irrigation. So that's kept on. The water will come off there now. So I'll clip this back up. So we're all secure. So now I'm just going to add the extra irrigation from this anti-siphon part and straight into the greenhouse. So now I've got these little pegs that I'm going to place on every station of the tomatoes, and basically this clips onto here like so, and then a drip feeder will add onto it as well. So like so, and then each feeder then will be joined to a T-junction. All right, let's get that done. So it's all set up, it completely takes it off grid. I'm so happy that now, if I go away or I can't come over here because of my shifts at the hospital, I can leave this greenhouse to water itself, and no longer will I be having that anxiety like we all get of to get over the plot to water your greenhouse. So I'll put the link in the description for the product, and it's, to me, it's well worth it. In a few days time, you know, a few weeks, I'll review it again and just, but the so far so good. So I'm so glad that that's all done now. Thank you again, Gardening Naturally, for sending me that. You know, I explained why I needed the four pod, which they sent me about a month ago, and I explained to them, you know, because I work in the hospital, I struggle sometimes to get up here in the mornings and water. And, you know, working in a hospital on those shifts, you get home and you're just exhausted. And you all know having your garden, your plot, that is so time consuming to be watering everything. And Gardening Naturally said, you know what, we're going to send you a watering system for your greenhouse. And they were lifesavers. So thank you again. I've done so much things that I haven't shown you. So the other day I popped over after my shift and I popped in one of my courgette plants that looked like it was desperate to go out. You know, I put some very fine straw around it, and the slugs hate going on that because they don't want it to be stuck to them. And I'm finding that such a lifesaver as well. Like, I put some around my runner beans this year, and I also put some around my courgettes. I also put out some pumpkins as well. I put out the baby boos, Jappy Littles, and one called the Blazing F1. So they're all small climbing pumpkins, and they're all going to climb all over this archway here. So I did that as well. I also put straw all around the strawberries, as you've seen. I've just done so many little jobs, just patching over, and I'm adapting my new job and my new shifts around, you know, my garden in time. So as you know, it can be a struggle, especially when you've got such a lovely summer's day. And do you really want to be out in the heat, just, you know, sweating, putting all that stuff in the ground and watering as well? You know, I can now go away for a few days and have someone look after the chickens and know that my greenhouse is all watered and it's looking after itself. So to have a self-sufficient greenhouse is a life changer. So I'm absolutely over the moon for that. I'm considering getting one as well for the mini polytunnel myself. And, you know, if it works out, then maybe I'll do some of the other beds as well. So having a watering system in for them as well would be a massive help. So yeah, the garden is looking amazing. It was supposed to be really muggy and rainy today, but the weather has turned around. So I'm just going to potch on, do a few jobs. So you can never plan going in the garden. You can never think, okay, today's the day, I'm just going to do one or two things. I was going to clean the shed out today and sort out the greenhouse because it was going to rain, and look what's happened. Glorious then. So I have to admit that having this water feature has been a massive asset. You know, I just love the fact that I can hear it in the background at all times when I'm walking the plot. But on top of that, I've left it continuously running, even day and night. I haven't switched it off, and it's not drained any power from the solar panels because the sun is just recharging it back up through the day. So I'm just going to keep it on through the summer now, and I'll just switch it off then once it starts draining on the power and the sun starts lowering and there's not enough light. But for now, it stays on. So as you can see, the corn is looking amazing now. It's really, really rooted in, and it was looking really sorry for himself last week, and it's come back leaps and bounds. Once it roots in and gets a good water in, you know, starting to bush up now, and before long it'll shoot up and it'll give it some good height. The baby boo and the Jappy Little, they've grown already as well, and also the shikuri over in the corner. I think there's also a Blazing F1 in there, and there's also what else did I put in? They put something else in as well. Butternut squash. I squeezed the butternut squash in as well, and I also put the same over there. The strawberries. Oh, look at the size of this strawberry. So I'm going to leave that for tomorrow, but there's so many here that I'm going to harvest today. So they're all in there. They're just little red gems. So I don't tend to take that many home at this time. You know, I tend to just use them as plot snacks, you know, and I'm sure you do the same. You know, once you see a few, you just keep eating them on the way while you're doing your jobs. Let me show you what I'm going to do here. So I've harvested some of this, and the lettuces, there's still quite a few in here and some spring onions. I might transplant them over to somewhere else, give it a good weed. And I think this needs to be my bed for the leeks, because, you know, I'm just running out of space. I've already got salad on the bottom, so it doesn't matter, but I will transplant these and hopefully, you know, they should be okay. I've done that before and it's been all right, you know, using this as a bit of a nursery and then moving the spring onions on and whatnot. But I need some space for some leeks, and the swede as well needs to grow up as well. So I'm gonna finish off harvesting the last of the spring cabbage, and then they can go in there in a couple of days' time. Everything else is just growing quick now. So the runner beans are all looking okay. They're not eating as much as I thought because the straw is really helping. The Liberty beans off Terry King, they have shot up. They're almost at the top now of the canes. And the first early potatoes, as you can see, they're going a bit yellow now, so it just means that they're almost ready to harvest and all the rest. These are also the same first earlies, and the main crops are all still going on strong. Sweet peas are looking amazing. They're climbing up now. Last of the spring cabbages. These were called April. I've got three or four left. The artichokes is again off Tony O'Neill. They're coming on great as well. I popped them into a bucket this year, 30 litre bucket, because whatever you do, don't put them in the ground. My gooseberry didn't give me any fruit this year. This is the red gooseberry. I pruned it back hard, and next year I should get a lovely flush of fruit. Some herbs, the herbs are looking great as well. And so are my sunflowers. Of all the places I planted sunflowers, the ones near the chickens are the safest. Hanging baskets, they're looking okay, and the baskets on the front. The lobelia is now starting to come back a bit more. So I'm hoping they'll give me a nice flush of colour. Also in here, the chilies, the peppers, and the bush tomatoes. I already had two tomatoes off this one. This was a mystery tomato plant, was in the greenhouse. And it was, I didn't know when I planted it whether it was a vine, but obviously it was a bush. So I've taken it out. And I've planted it into here because obviously I don't need the height here. And I've planted another tomato plant in the greenhouse in replacement of it. So, look. How is this here? Mare's tail. The devil. The Aji mango, which I failed at last year, is really bushing out now. So I've got two of those, so I'm really happy. And the ones from a Tesco's pepper. A pointed Tesco pepper, they're looking the best. So I'm really pleased. And then over here, the King of the North peppers. So the good thing about this tunnel as well is that it's forecast rain for tonight, and I will leave this open, and then tomorrow I'll come over later on after it's had a good water in and close it back up. But you know, it's nice that you can just leave it open this high and let have some good natural rain. And the good thing about it as well is that the wind cannot blow it over. So when I built this, I added some tension wire so it's connected here. So you can unclip it, but it stops it from going anywhere if the wind wants to blow it. It keeps it open, but also keeps it shut. And I just connected it to the shed. The problem I got at the moment is that I haven't got enough space, but I've got loads of plants to go out. And then what will happen is I'll harvest everything and I'll have loads of space. So it's all about planning and preparing your beds, and I've done that to the best I can, but you all know that that can never happen fully. You know, there's always something that's waiting to go out. I've still got one bed here and another bed down here that I've still got for my swede and my leeks, as I mentioned, so I'm not worried, but later on there'll be space, I'm sure, that I could have put somewhere else. But all the garlic is out now, but I'm not sure what to put in there. I might plant out some more lettuces because it gets a bit of shade from the grapevine, and at least I'll have an extra bit of a crop later on in the season. So right. I thought on a future video, if you're all interested, I thought I'd show you my whole solar system, my whole solar energy system. Loads of people keep commenting on saying, like, can you just go in depth more about the solar, you know, energy and how you have your plot. And it's so easy. It's easy once you know how. Like, I remember when I first started, I just didn't have a clue. And it's quite easy, but as long as you follow the steps. So I'll post a video soon of how I've got lights in my greenhouse, in my potting shed and tool shed, and how I've got like water features and yeah, everything else that runs on my solar energy, so that my plot is pretty much looks after itself now. So I'm so happy. So again, thank you Gardening Naturally for all what you've done. But just look over there, just look at this. Like I've fallen in love with it, honestly. Just go through the fruit trees and all the summer flowers that are going to be here, and you know, the alliums that are going to burst up soon. There's already some flowers coming, and I think next year I'm going to run some logs across here and actually mulch this with a nice good amount of soil and compost, so that this will have a good feed, and this will be always be the sort of like a summer wildflower area. But look, I just love the fact that it's not pouring out, it's just trickling out, and that sound. So as I always say, thanks again for watching, guys. And if you haven't already, why not subscribe? Pop a little subscription. It's free, doesn't cost you nothing. Just subscribe to my channel, and it means the world to me. So take care, guys, and I'll see you all again soon.